pretty obvious why people long for. Worst documentary ever.
Like 50, 55 miles an hour is like super fun. There are some downsides to longboarding, like stupid drivers on the road, you know, people that just don't see you and they're just not looking out for you. They have no idea what's going on when you ride by and they just don't know what to do. And they pull out in front of you or stop when you're behind them or do some crazy stuff. But then again, there are upsides to cars. Sometimes people give you rides up the hills, so it's pretty nice. Walking up hills is tiring, so the more runs you can get with the energy you have, the better. Really fun. Try it someday.
Every time the moon shines, I become alive.
You know, it's just part of the struggle. I mean, for every downhill, there's always an uphill.
Have you guys ever been kicked out of a place for longboarding?
Every day. No.
Every day.
Yeah.
This neighborhood.
Yeah,
we're riding in.
We've been kicked out of here. We've been kicked out of Clackamas. Yes.
Just, we do. Just the other day, we were skating down this hill. And this post office lady parks in the middle of that intersection over there, and then like we skate past her, and she's like, "I'm gonna call the cops if you guys don't leave." Like, we're just riding down the hill. We didn't know it was. It's not illegal. I don't think it's illegal.
It's not illegal. It's frowned upon.
Like masturbating on an airplane.
People are so sensitive after that.
Like, yeah, it's just part of the struggle.
Say something, G.
How?
My name's Alberto Harrigan, and I've been skating for 8 years. Let's see, all my friends, sixth grade. It's kind of like the thing to do, I guess. That's not really a good reason to start it, but it was fun. But that was mainly the thing that kind of seduced me, I guess, if you want to say that.
So basically, I have some friends at school that were all doing longboarding and they wanted me to try it. And it looked pretty scary, but I got, you know, just started doing it and it was a whole lot of fun.
How long ago did you start?
Earlier this year. So I've only been longboarding for a few months, but still.
What do you like about it?
I like the rush, because once you start riding, you can't really stop like you would snowboarding, where you can just slow down and just bail. Like, once you're longboarding, I mean, you're on the road and the only way to, you know, stop is to jump off, but that's, you're gonna die, so it's crazy.
What don't you like about it?
Days like this, when it's wet, because these are the days that you shouldn't be riding. I mean, you can slip out, it's not smart.
Does that looks bad.
Dude, I like hit my neck on this. Well, as you can see, I just fell and I was coming around this curb, or this, you know, this corner right here, but it's all wet. So my board slipped out and my body slid all the way up to the curb and I hit the back of my neck. So that could have been bad. It's just how it is. Longboarding. You know, there's not a whole lot I can say other than, you know, it hurts.
Damn it!
I suck at longboarding.
Yeah, there was one time that I crashed when I was still first learning how to longboard with my first longboard, and I was going down this hill by my school without a helmet, and I was probably going around 35 miles an hour, and I was going so fast that my board started to wobble. It's called the speed wobbles, and I fell off my board, and I mean, it could have been really dangerous, but I ended up being fine, and I walked away with a small scar, but nothing big, but yeah. We're at home.
Hey, you got me, bro?
Yeah, dude. Don't worry about stop signs. You can speed up.
Yeah, just go through him, dude. He'll hurt himself. Go faster.
Ew!
Woo-hoo!
Well, I mean, of course, you are gonna fall and, like, get, like, since you're falling going 30 miles an hour, of course you're gonna hurt something. But, I mean, you just gotta know your limits. Like, you're not just gonna go, like, 50 miles an hour if you've never done it, or, like, if you've never even got close to doing it, because of course you're gonna fall and get scared. But if you're really, like, good at it and you feel like you can do it, well, then, yeah, it's worth it. It's worth the try. But, I mean, it's all in God's hand if you fall or not. Yourself.
I've never broken a bone, thank God, or thank goodness. I've got pretty hurt, got some few scars, knocked the wind out of me, credit card. I'm not gonna get into details about that, but if you want me to? Okay, so I was trying to trick down a set of stairs and the board went up my rear end. School appropriate right there, so. It's definitely worth the pain. I mean, every sport, no matter what you do, you're gonna get hurt. I mean, you can get hurt driving a car, you can get hurt running. So if I get hurt skateboarding, then it's not really a big deal to me because I'm actually having fun. It's actually worthwhile, it's fun to do. Keeps you out of trouble. So it's definitely something you can pick up and have fun and do it regardless of getting hurt.
Yeah, one time I was riding this hill called Zoo Bomb, and you start at the top of the Oregon Zoo, and you just ride the max up, take the elevator up, and you're there. It's one of the best hills there is because it's a free ride up every time. So anyway, I was riding that hill. I've done it many times, but there's this one specific part where you gotta bomb through a four-way stop. It's pretty crazy. This one lady, I looked at her face before she pulled out in front of me, and she pulled out and stopped, and apparently she didn't see me. She ran the stop sign, and I hit the back of her car, flipped over her car, and landed on the pavement, and went to the hospital. It's pretty gnarly. Like, cracked her rib and stuff, got a concussion. It wasn't that fun, but I don't know, I've had many crashes. I mean, skitching cars is pretty dangerous. Just fat hills, getting speed wobbles, you gotta make sure you're on top of your board. You gotta keep it clean. You gotta do meticulous work with it. You gotta make sure everything's working good. Your bearings aren't gonna stop up. You gotta make sure all your nuts and screws and wheels are all in shape and order and good to go. And then you'll be good to hit some hills. Fun stuff.
I just quit longboarding from a terrible accident. You can see I hurt my hands, my elbow, my knee, and part of my ass. I now just quit. I never want to longboard again. It's not worth it. I was going down a hill and got the wobbles and had to run it out. I even got scabs on the bottom of my feet. Wrong foot. This foot. see that? Hurts real bad. So, longboarding is not worth it, and I quit.
So what's your view on longboarding?
Well, you know, there's your good days and your bad days. Clearly today is a freaking good day. I mean, as you can see. But then there's the bad days, and you know, you just gotta pull through, you know, accept what life throws at you, and just, yeah.
And when people try to run you off the road?
Yeah, when people try to hit you off the freaking road and kill you, you know, that doesn't help. But you know, it's just life. I mean, it's part of the struggle. Longboard struggle. Give me a boner.